a triangle. The logical proof I am giving here. First one, we have taken the given is triangle PQR, and theorem says that sum of angles of a triangle is 180 degrees. So what is given and what to be proved? Given is that triangle PQR, and you are required to prove angle 1 plus 2 plus 3 is equal to 180 degrees. So to prove this logically, we need to construct a line L parallel to QR, that is the base here. I am doing that. By doing like that, what is happening? Two more angles, 4 and 5, are formed here. And remember, angle L is parallel to angle QR, therefore PQ is a transversal, PR is another transversal. Therefore, angle 4 and 2 are alternate interior angles, a pair of alternate interior angles, therefore they are equal. Similarly, 5 and 3 are also make a pair of alternate interior angles, so they are also equal. So those equalities I will write first in the proof. Angle 2 equal to angle 4 because they are a pair of alternate interior angles, and angle 3 equal to angle 5, they also make a pair of alternate interior angles. Now sum of angles 1 plus 2 plus 3 will be equal to, in place of 2 I am writing 4, in place of 3 I am writing 5. So angle 1 plus 2 plus 3 is nothing but angle 1 plus angle 4 plus angle 5, and 1 plus 4 plus 5 together it is a straight angle here, therefore it is 180 degrees, angle on a straight line. Therefore we have proved that angle 1 plus angle 2 plus angle 3 equal to 180 degrees. This proof you have to remember very clearly. Hello, somebody is talking, tell me. Any doubt? Do you have any doubt, children?
No, sir.
Huh?
No, sir.
No doubt. Okay. Right. Now, let us.
Yes, sir.
Let us have another theorem. Another theorem, small theorem I am showing you here. That is exterior angle theorem. Yes, exterior angle theorem. Suppose for a triangle, one of the sides is produced. It forms an angle in the exterior of the triangle, and that is called exterior angle. For example, here you see exterior angle property. So this angle 120 degrees is called exterior angle. What is that called? Exterior angle, because for triangle ABC, AB is produced up to D here, a line, big line I am producing, and in the exterior the green angle is formed here. Right? So exterior angle CBD is equal to 120.38 degrees here. When you add C and A, also you are getting the same. See, sum of these two is nothing but 120.38. So will it happen only with the same measurements? No. It will also happen with the different measurements also. Okay? You can see when I am even changing the measures of angles, the exterior angle is the same. Exterior angle is the same, and it is the sum of the two angles here. It will happen with other angles. Suppose you can also produce BC towards this side, and you can check this angle is equal to the sum of these two angles or not. Similarly, this side also you can produce BA, CA also can be produced and check this way. So that you have to do as an activity at home, you check it on your own. Now I want to check whether these can be done using paper cutting activity like activity. The activity, now I am going to rotate this angle C and put here, and I am going to bring this angle A also and put here. Will angle A and C together completely cover angle CBD or not, I am going to check. Now I am moving angle C, it is coming slowly towards this side. It occupied some place, it occupied some area in angle CBD. Now I am bringing angle A also towards this side, I am bringing it like this. See, together these two angles are covering the entire measure of angle CBD. Therefore, we can say exterior angle made by producing any side of the triangle is equal to sum of its opposite interior angles. See here, angle C and A are opposite angles for this angle. Angle C here, angle A here are opposite interior angles. And this angle here, children, this angle, let me mark here with some color. I will mark with blue, and the angle here I am going to, you see this angle, this angle is adjacent angle. These two are called adjacent angles. They make a linear pair, you all know that. I need not tell you separately. And these two are called opposite interior angles. This is adjacent interior angle. This blue colored angle, this violet colored angle is adjacent interior angle. One of you repeat please. Pavani, adjacent interior angle. Other two angles are called opposite interior angles. So, these two angles are covering the entire space of this angle, and there now we proved that exterior angle is equal to sum of interior angles. Now, so two theorems we have just seen. One is, are you all following, Meghana, Akshay, Bhavya?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
So you have to follow the presentation as well as immediately write it down. When you write it down, it will be easy for you to make the notes immediately. So what all we learned so far, we learned the sum of angles of a triangle is 180 degrees. Exterior angle made by producing one of the sides of a triangle is equal to the sum of its interior opposite angles or opposite interior angles.
The presentation stopped.
What?
Presentation stopped.
Presentation, I stopped it. Now, am I appearing to you or not? Am I there on the screen?
Yes, sir.
What?
Yes, sir.
I am there on the screen for you, no? Is it not? I stopped the presentation just now. Any doubt?
Yes,
Monish?
Sir.
Monish? This exterior angle property you need not write. Only angle sum property you have to write. That's why I explained it two times. Now, let us come back to the present screen option again to do exercises from problems from exercise 6.3. One by one, we will check again on the screen. On present screen option, I will show you. So, alert, be alert. When I call you, you open your mic, unmute your mic and talk to me. Okay? Right. I will call you by names. You have to immediately answer my questions when I ask you during the presentation. Right. Monish, are you ready? Ready to have the screen share? Monish, not talking.
Yes, sir.
That's good. Now, this exterior angle property is there. Now we have finished it. I am closing it down. Next, I am opening 6.3, question number 1. This is from exercise 6.3, question 1. In this, there is a boon for us, all of us children. In the geometry problems, it is clear that almost for every problem, we will have a support figure to understand the problem easily. That is a boon for us. That is a help for us. Now, here is a triangle PQR and two angles are marked. Let us see what is the question here. Question is, given QP and RQ of triangle PQR are produced. QP, this is QP, it is produced, and we got an angle, exterior angle here, 135 degrees. That is angle SPR, angle SPR. Then angle PQT we got by producing RQ. RQ is produced to T to have triangle PQ, angle PQT, that is 110 degrees. All this is given. Now let us see, two angles are formed here. Two angles are formed, the interior angles I am showing here, angle 1 and angle 2. Finding angle 1 and angle 2 is easy. We have to find angle PRQ first. PRQ, this brown angle we have to find. But to find that one, I am taking the help of the other two interior angles of the triangle. I am blinking them. Did you all observe this blinking? Angle 1 and 2. Angle 1 and 2 are blinking. These angle 1 and 2 you have to find. To find
70 degrees.
Whatever it is, let us first step in the solution we will do. Angle 1 plus SPR, that is this angle, is equal to 180 degrees because they make a linear pair. Therefore, 1 equal to 180 degrees minus SPR, 180 degrees minus 135, that is 45 degrees. So, what is angle number? Angle 1, that is 135 degrees. Now, let us find what is angle 2.
45 degrees, sir.
Angle R is equal to 55 degrees.
Very good, very good, good. Those whoever is telling, they are all good. You wait for my demonstration. Angle 2 here is marked like this. Angle 2 and 110 degrees together is making a linear pair 180 degrees. Angle 2 equal to 180 degrees minus 110, so 70 degrees. Now, angle 1 plus 2 plus angle PRQ is equal to sum of angles of a triangle 180 degrees. Yeah, very good, very good, very good. This is what 1 plus 2 plus PRQ is equal to 180 degrees. That is because of angle sum property of a triangle. So 45 degrees plus 70 degrees plus PRQ equal to 180. So therefore, PRQ equal to these two together is 115. 115 plus PRQ equal to 180. So PRQ equal to 180 minus 115, 65 degrees. Those who can note down, quickly you note down, I'll give you 30 seconds of time to note down. And anyway, question and figure you can note down slowly from the textbook. Only solution you copy quickly. So, did you all understand this problem?
Yes, sir.
It is also an important problem.
Yeah.
All the problems from the exercise 6.3 are important. So, do them 2 times, 3 times till you do them without any disturbance, till you do them without seeing. Okay? Keep practicing like this. So today, whatever I'll give you in the classwork, please note down in the classwork as well as in the homework also, so that you will have a practice, right? Now let us go for question number 2. Shall we move on to question number 2? Did you all copy?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Meghna, can I go for the third question? A second question? Akshaya?
Yes.
Akshaya?
Yes, sir.
Now, let us move on to question number 2. This I don't want to save. Okay, question number 2 now. Now, this is question number 2 for you. On the screen again. Supriya, are you following? Supriya?
Yes, sir.
Very good. Roshan Teja?
Yes, sir.
Good. Now, in question 2, I am going to erase all these first for you, and I don't want this view also. Now the question, now the figure is very clear to you. Angle, triangle XYZ is given and angles are marked here. Angle X is 62 degrees and angle XYZ is 54 degrees. You may ask me, when I am talking about angle X, only angle X I am telling, and angle Y, why are you telling XYZ? See, at Y, it is a combination of two angles, children. One angle here, another angle here. So, when a combination is appearing, you have to specify it correctly by a three-lettered marking, by a three-lettered naming. X, Y, Z, meaning the entire angle here, that is 54. Now, what is given, we will see. Given in the question that, in triangle XYZ, angle X is 62 degrees, angle XYZ is 54 degrees, YO is the line segment bisector of angle XYZ. Bisector means the line that makes the angle into two parts exactly. That means this line is making this 54 degrees into two equal parts. Similarly, OZ is the bisector, ZY is the bisector of angle XZY. Therefore, that also makes that Z angle Z into two equal parts. We need to find angle OZY and YOZ. OZY is the smaller angle and YOZ is this pink colored angle. Now let us mark the angle Z also here, because we need to find OZY, which is half of angle, complete angle Z here, or XZY. Therefore, we need to find this angle here, this blue colored angle. So how to find that one? We need to find the third angle first, that is angle Z, XZY. XZY is equal to sum of angles of a triangle is 180 minus the given two angles 62 plus 54, that is 116. So the third angle Z is equal to, or XZY is equal to 64. Now the next step is to find OZY. So I will find OZY first. I am marking these two angles. See the angles now. OZY, are they blinking? Green colored and purple color, are they blinking?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, you can see the blinking like this.
Yes, sir.
If you want, I can make it bigger, but now blinking can be clearly seen, I think. Right. Now, see this one. We have to find what is OZY. So, we will have, that is nothing but half of XZY. Half of XZY, that is half of 64, that is 32 degrees. Now we have these two, one more angle we found, this green colored angle we found. If we know this purple color also, then we can easily find the third angle of this triangle YOZ. Now purple color angle, for that is nothing but half of XYZ. Purple color angle OYZ is equal to angle half of angle XYZ, that is half of 54 degrees, 27 degrees. Now, two angles of this smaller triangle inside YOZ, we know this purple color angle and green color angle. Now, pink colored angle we find. That is how you have to take this. In triangle YOZ plus OZY, OYZ plus OZY is equal to 180 degrees by angle sum property. Therefore, we have YOZ that we don't know plus this OYZ just now found 27, and XZY we found 32. So these two angles I am putting in this, and now YOZ is equal to 180 degrees minus sum of these two is 59, and it is 121 degrees. Did you all understand this problem?
Yes, sir.
Very good. Purnachandu.
Yes, sir.
Purnachandu, Siddhartha.
Yes, sir.
Very good. Tejesh. Those who are interested can take a screenshot.
Yes, sir.
Otherwise, you copy this immediately. Now we will move on to question number 3. All these problems are logic based problems, children. We are using only one theorem, that is angle sum property, as well as whenever we are requiring, we are using the theorems we learned in learned about the parallel lines. Sometimes we may use exterior angle property also in the coming problems. Now we move on to the third problem. I am going to close this. Question number 3. Question number 3 here. Now what is given, let us understand. Given is that AB, the line here, is parallel to DE. Parallel to DE. So parallel lines properties we have to use, angles properties, etc. And BAC or BAE also we can say the same angle, that is 35 degrees. And CDE, in this triangle CDE, is given given 53 degrees. We have to find DCE, that is what is marked in red color here. Very simple steps, only two steps are there in this problem. One, find this angle. This is 35 and angle AED you have to find, because these two lines are parallel. This line, they are alternate interior angles. Alternate interior angles, so they are equal. Therefore, I made it in the same color, green color there. So, solution. First, we need to find AED. AED, it is nothing but CED also. That is 35 degrees C. That is equal to 35 degrees BAC, because they are alternate, a pair of alternate interior angles. Okay, now the second step, we know this green angles, two green angles we know in this triangle, only that red colored marked angle only we have to find. So therefore we will use now angle sum property again here. Now in triangle DCE, angle DCE plus angle DCE plus angle CDE plus angle CED is equal to 180 degrees. So DCE found, CDE, that is that they have given 53, and CED we just found, that is nothing but AED, that is 35 degrees. So sum of these two, if you subtract from 180, you get what is the third angle. Third angle is equal to 180 degrees minus 88 degrees, 53 plus 35, 88 is equal to 92 degrees. Very simple problem. Okay, so we used here alternate interior angles property of parallel lines when intersected by a transversal. The angles formed in the alternate interior angles are equal, alternate positions are equal. Then we also used the angle sum property of triangles, that's all. Okay, this is a simple problem but also important. Any doubt about this problem?
No, sir.
No, no, sir.
Vishnu?
No, sir.
Venkatesh? Venugopal? No doubt.
No, sir.
Very good, very good. Now, shall we close this screen share? Come back to
yes,
the normal class. Now, I will stop sharing here. I will be appearing in front of you. At the same time, I will present the screen for the attendance. Okay? So, wait for a while.